Welcome to a lesson on logistic growth using recursive formulas. In this lesson, we'll derive a recursive logistic growth equation and also find population levels using logistic growth. In our basic exponential growth scenario, we had a recursive equation in the form p sub n equals p sub n minus 1 plus r, the growth rate expressed as a decimal, times p sub n minus 1. In a confined environment, however, the growth rate may not remain constant. In a lake, for example, there is some maximum sustainable population of fish, also called a carrying capacity, where the carrying capacity or maximum sustainable population is the largest population that an environment can support. Consider a lake with a carrying capacity of 10,000 fish. The growth rate may look like that shown in the graph below. Notice how when the population is 10,000, the growth rate would be zero because 10,000 is the carrying capacity. However, if the population is below 10,000, notice how the growth rate would be positive and therefore the population would be increasing. If the population happened to go beyond 10,000, notice how the growth rate would be negative and therefore the population would be decreasing. So looking at this recursive equation here for exponential growth, if we can find the equation for the growth rate, we could perform a substitution for this r here and have a recursive formula for logistic growth. So if we want to find the equation of this line here, notice how the y-intercept is 0.05. And if we want to find the slope using these two points here, notice how we'd have to go down 0.05 units and right 10,000 units, which means the slope would be negative 0.05 divided by 10,000. And this is all we need in order to find the equation for the growth rate. Using the slope-intercept form of a line, or the form y equals mx plus b, we could write it as y equals b plus mx instead. So in our case, we'd have r equals the y-intercept, which is 0.05, plus the slope, which is negative 0.05 divided by 10,000, times the input variable, which in this case would be p, the population. So this is the equation for our growth rate. Notice how if we factor out 0.05, we could write this as a product. We'd have 0.05 times the quantity 1 minus p divided by 10,000. This is what we'll substitute for r in our recursive equation. So by performing this substitution, which is here in our recursive equation, we now have a recursive formula for p sub n. P sub n equals p sub n minus 1 plus this product here times p sub n minus 1. This is a recursive equation that models logistic growth. So to generalize this, if a population is growing in a constrained environment with a carrying capacity k, and absent constraint would grow exponentially with a growth rate r, then the population behavior can be described by the logistic growth model given here, which we just derived. Again, k is the carrying capacity and r is the growth rate absent constraint. Unlike linear and exponential growth, logistic growth behaves differently if the populations grow steadily throughout the year or if they have one breeding time per year. The recursive formula provided above models generational growth where there is one breeding time per year, or at least a finite number of breeding times per year. So going back to our fish example, let's say 2,000 fish are introduced to a lake with a carrying capacity of 10,000. Absent any restrictions, the fish population would grow at 5% per year. Find the population after 1, 2, and 3 years. So looking at the given information, the starting population p sub 0 is equal to 2,000. The carrying capacity is 10,000, so k is 10,000. And the growth rate absent restrictions is 5%, and therefore r is 5%, expressed as a decimal would be 0.05. And using our recursive logistic growth equation, we can now find the population after 1, 2, and 3 years. Notice r is 0.05, k is 10,000, and we need p sub 0 to find p sub 1. P sub 1 equals 2,000 plus 0.05 times the quantity 1 minus 2,000 divided by 10,000 times 2,000, which would give us 2,080. Notice how once we found p sub 1, we can now find p sub 2. We need p sub 1 to find p sub 2 because this is a recursive equation. Just like we used 2,000 here, here, and here to find p sub 1, we need 2,080 here, here, and here to find p sub 2. And then we need p sub 2 here, here, and here to find p sub 3. Now let's look at this graphically. This blue graph models the logistic growth. Notice the carrying capacity of 10,000 is here. Notice as the population approaches 10,000, the growth rate slows. In comparison, the red graph would be the exponential growth without any restrictions. If we zoom in on this piece of the graph here, we can see for a short period of time, the logistic growth and the exponential growth are very similar, but as time passes, the logistic growth rate slows, while the exponential growth rate does not. I hope you found this introduction helpful. Thank you for watching.